Morning, everyone. It's a pleasure to be here. Thank you, Todd and Mark, for putting this together and actually giving us the opportunity to support the event. And also a special thanks, because I think this is the closest I'm going to get to Broadway. So thank you for giving me the most fun location from which to do. I've been at a lot of convention centers, but this is just a gorgeous location. So thank you for giving me that opportunity. And I think we've had the stage set for us. We've talked about open, we've talked about agents. I'm going to stick with the theme. Mark already said we know the answer. The answer is 42. So we just have to get all the agents in place to get us to the answer. But honestly, I want to begin first by the reason we're all excited here. We see, after a long time, we are at the cusp of a truly transformative technology. And these transformative technologies haven't had often. I think in human history, you can talk about 7 or 8 times in which you've had technologies that have the potential to change every profession, every walk of life, every industry. It takes time, but we think it will happen. And we all feel enthused by the opportunity. And when you talk about numbers like, you know, depending on who you ask and how long, $4 trillion of economic opportunity by AI, you know that that isn't going to happen unless the technology is available for everybody and widely deployed. And we fundamentally believe that that's not just about consuming AI technology, but to provide the community with the power to create it, produce it, adapt it, shape it, inform it, and create it. So that's why the theme of the talk here really is, and we have a lot of words that try and put artificial intelligence together. We have had artificial general intelligence, AGI. It's a term I hate. These days I go around, my colleagues and I, we talk about artificial useful intelligence. And I certainly believe that community intelligence and artificial intelligence together is more likely to create useful intelligence than anything else. So that's what I wanted to talk about. I want to begin first with, we have heard this skepticism before, and especially in this most recent incarnation of AI. If maybe even 3 years back, 2 years back, you said open technologies in AI are going to be at the forefront, there was skepticism, because the assumption was you need enormous capital, you need enormous investment. There are secret sauce training recipes. There is specialized expertise. There is no way that open technologies in AI are going to really be at the forefront and move the needle. And in reality, in just a matter of a couple of years, I think we have seen the story change quite dramatically. Today, in front of us, we have access to state-of-the-art models. Those models have become much more usable. We are starting to see the emergence of open frameworks and tools, and I'll share a little bit more of what we see. But I certainly think that the skepticism around the fact that open will always be behind proprietary tech, I think has actually been put to bed quite aggressively and actually much faster in AI than in the history of open source. And it's a little, it's fun to sort of look back. And if you look at, you know, the original journey of open source that I'm sure many of you here shaped and have been a part of, it took us a couple of decades of innovation to figure out how to go from the intent to do things in the open to being able to do things in the open robustly. That was a couple of decades of journey. And it required a lot of innovation. It was innovations in technology, innovations in tools, innovations in licenses, innovations in governance, innovations in ways of working, right? Whether it was, you know, foundations, GitHub, pull requests, software foundations. It took a lot of innovation and a couple of decades to figure out how to really do things in the open effectively at scale. And of course, along with that came business models, et cetera. But I think what is actually very, very interesting is this journey has actually been ultra accelerated in AI. What took 2 decades for general purpose open source software to accomplish, I think has actually happened in AI in a couple of years. We're at the early stages, but I think that journey has accelerated in a couple of years, building on a lot of the innovations that already happened in open source software. So if you step back and look at what we see happening in the world of AI, I think the rate and pace of progress is unprecedented. And we've seen this journey now, if you will, and I look at it in 3 stages. First, since models are the artifacts of modern AI, certainly the first thing was we needed to start having models in the open. And we've started seeing that happen. More and more powerful models starting to get released in the open. Just a few, there are many more out there. It was very clear, though, of course, that models aren't the answer. You have to actually build useful things around models. So tools and frameworks that let you manipulate models. And By the way, just on models, we have also seen the answer change from one model to rule them all, one model that does everything for everybody, into now collections of fit-for-purpose small models. Anybody remember the Unix philosophy? Do one thing right, do that very, very well. We're starting to see that apply to models. You have lightweight embedding models, models that do speech well, VLM models that do document processing, small LLMs that are good for what you need to do. So we are starting to see usable, special purpose, fit for purpose models that are actually a good building blocks to build useful applications. So we have seen an evolution in models. Around models, now we have seen tools and frameworks develop. Everybody's favorite application archetype is RAG. What are the frameworks for RAG? How do I use models to call tools? We have now seen more and more frameworks emerge to start to help you put this together. We are early in the journey, but what's exciting is how quickly the narrative went from AI is going to be dominated by close proprietary models to, in 24 months, usable models, usable frameworks, and now the emergence of the world of agents. Like we said, we're sticking with the theme. The ability for models to not just be able to, we have moved very quickly in 2 years from models are tokens in, tokens out, to models can take a task, decompose the task, plan a set of actions, call tools, access knowledge, really start putting it together. So what's been very, very exciting is how quickly this journey has happened in AI and the exciting potential around it. And IBM as a company, we've been committed to open in many ways for a long time, and we've starting to contribute a lot to this ecosystem. So maybe spend a little bit of time on how we approach this most recent era of AI and how we are thinking about it. Look, both in AI and in open, we've been around as a company for a long time. We have been in the journey of AI, actually from the time the word AI was coined in 1956. I believe that was a Dartmouth conference in which actually IBM sponsored the conference where the word AI was coined. So we've been in that journey. We have gone all the way from chess playing machines to Jeopardy playing machines to LLM. So we've seen that journey. We've also been part of the open journey from Linux to the Apache Software Foundation to Eclipse to Java to Kubernetes. We've been through that journey. And we began in this most recent era of AI, really by when we announced our platform in 2023, it was already based on a foundation of open technology. So we were certainly clear that the platform for AI is something that we're going to embrace, contribute, and evolve through open. So we have doubled down on PyTorch, projects like VLLM, OpenAI Triton for hardware agnostic kernels, Kubeflow, and so on to build our horizontal AI platform. In 2024, we decided that it made sense to start open sourcing our models. Now, we were certainly never in the business of building the giant model that rules the world, that does everything. That doesn't make sense for us from an enterprise perspective. But it was clear that models as a foundational building block made sense to release in the open. So we started to release our models called Granite. Up here, you'll get to go and experience the Granite models. We started with a family of code models. And we have now, you know, last month we had our release 3.2. We now release a family of models in the spirit of fit-for-purpose models. We release models for doing time series work. We do vision language models. We release embedding models. We release models in a range of sizes that let you run from the CPU to something that can run on a reasonable size GPU, less than 10 billion parameters that really are workable and usable. The second thing is we have started to release in the open a set of projects that let you do things around the model. So the first example of one of the things that we were very interested in is this work called InstructLab. And there's actually a pad out there called InstructLab. The goal of InstructLab is to figure out customization of model as a data science activity. Can we make it as simple as possible so that the task of teaching a model a new skill or a new piece of knowledge can be made as rapid and as simple as possible? So InstructLab is an open source project that tries to help you make model customization and tuning an open activity. Now, we all know that value in AI is going to come not simply by using a model, but you can bring your own data, whether it's your enterprise data or personal data, to the model. Data processing at scale of unstructured data is essential to get value from AI. So two projects called Dockling and Data Prep Kit. Data Prep Kit lets you do large-scale unstructured data processing. And it's actually built on technology we created to do massive scale processing to build our own models. We concluded that all of the troubles we went to do large scale unstructured data processing, every developer out there is going to face when they prepare data to feed into our application, when they prepare data to index it to for a RAG use case, when they prepare data to customize a model. So Data Prep Kit is really a seamless way in which you can do unstructured data processing. Start from a laptop, scale it to the cloud, and go that way. And then DocLink has been one of those things that we released that's been amazingly well received by the community. It's a project that in 3 months now has over 24,000 stars, over 1,000 forks. DocLink solves that pesky problem of trying to take data that sits in PDFs and Excels and PPTs and structured formats, turn it into things that you can actually feed into a model. Turns it into JSON, turns it into Markdown, turns it into HTML text that models can actually work with. So that's sort of the second category of tools. And then finally, of course, we have to talk about agents. And I think Mark already presaged this to us. We've released actually a family of projects. B is not just one project, it's actually a family of projects. And our observation came from there are going to be, because we are early in the game, a lot of frameworks for building agents. We're all as a community trying to figure out what this new abstraction is. Agents are certainly a new application archetype. We went from application archetypes where you program an application today, please do this, please use these services, coding an algorithm, into an application archetype where you're declaring an end goal to an LLM, and you're expecting the LLM to go figure out what tools to call, what data to integrate, right? So it's a different archetype. And so there's going to be lots of frameworks that are going to enable people to build agents. So one of the goals of BAI, which we announced recently at the AI Dev Conference, is to really help orchestrate agents from multiple frameworks. I think it's too early to know as a community what is the right abstraction mechanism. So it's correct and essential that multiple frameworks, but then we want to be able to stitch together those frameworks. So that's why as part of BAI, we are starting to work in the open community by extending model context protocol that my previous speaker already introduced with a way to stitch agents together. So exciting stuff. The message here in the slide is we're committed to delivering useful projects in the open, whether it is models, whether it is tools that let you work with models, or whether it is agents that let you compose useful functionality all on top of an open platform. And we're going to continue to do that. And as a signal of our commitment, I am very, very happy to announce that we plan to contribute 3 projects to the Linux Foundation. We're announcing it this year. We plan to contribute it to the Linux Foundation with the intent of eventually being part of the Linux Foundation AI and data. The 3 projects we are going to contribute to the Linux Foundation are Data Prep Kit, which, like I said, lets you do large-scale unstructured data processing for AI, get your data ready for AI. DocLink, which lets you do document conversion and extraction, a very, very popular project. We are excited by what the community will do to continue to enhance it. And then BAI, which is a framework both to build agents as well as to orchestrate agents from multiple frameworks. So we are very excited by the opportunity to work in the open community to shape each one of these projects. And these are all projects that we are committed and invested in. In fact, Data Prep Kit is what we use as a base to also deliver enterprise-grade unstructured data processing. So this is something we want to work in the community to improve, but we certainly see a path to then offer value to our clients and partners. So excited about this, and I look forward to seeing what the community will do. I want to end with just going back to where we started. It's very clear to us that a transformative technology like AI isn't going to have the economic output and impact that we all wanted to have without the coming together of open approaches to collaboration. So as a company, we are committed to nurturing the community. Forums such as these that enable the open community to come together, collaborate, build new things is very, very exciting. And we certainly see our contributions both to existing projects as well as these new projects that we are contributing to the community as just a start of a journey to build really wonderful AI that impacts every profession, every part of the industry, and allows us to do fun things. We all know the answer already. Mark started with the answer. We just have to figure out an open path to get to the answer. With that, thank you for the opportunity, and hope you have a wonderful conference.